Today, I'm going to be starting probably my biggest miniature project that I've ever worked on. Hi, my name is Alex, and in this episode of Magic Missile Minis, I'm going to be working on a massive conversion. So as you guys know, that there have been a couple videos that I've been doing using these guys, some conversions for these Orc Gretchen. And now I'm going to be working on the project that I bought these miniatures for. This is going to be a really big project, and I'm really looking forward to it. So enough of this dilly-dallying, let's get into the project itself. On doing kind of like a large tower with one big old wheel at the very bottom of it. And so the first thing I need to do is make the main body of the tower itself. So I measure out a rectangle based on the size of some of the miniatures that I've got. But as you can see here, I actually want it to be tapered to make it feel a little bit more ramshackle and less perfect. Measuring out about half a centimeter at what's going to be the bottom of this guy. I also cut out a slot for where the wheel is going to be coming out of, scoring this styrene sheet that I'm using, and then bending the entire sheet of styrene where I've cut so that it kind of snaps off. So the next thing I need to do is make the wheel itself. So I start by measuring out a square, making that square the same length and size that I want the diameter of my circle to be. And then, as you can see me doing here, I draw a whole bunch of lines and do a whole bunch of measuring, as I desperately try to remember everything that I learned in geometry class. And after a bunch of that, I basically end up with something that looks like a summoning circle from Fullmetal Alchemist. So then I cut out the piece of styrene I've been drawing on from the rest of the styrene and try to decipher all of the different lines that I've drawn, and then get rid of all of the extra bits with some pliers. And after doing that a bunch, that leaves me with this. Yay, a shape. And then I decide to trace this shape rather than trying to make another Peter Trevelyan drawing. I then also cut out the shapes I'm going to use for the sides of this tower, and I also re-cut out the other shape that I used for the front because I found that it wasn't quite the right size, especially for the circle that I just made, and I wasn't about to do that all over again. And as you can see me doing here, I chop out a new little slot in this new piece that I had made based off of the circle that we had just made, or quote-unquote circle. Now I start working on actually connecting all the pieces of the tower together, cutting out a small strip of styrene that is going to be at the very bottom of the tower, attaching this to the side parts of the tower that I had made earlier using weld bond glue, which will melt the plastic a little bit so that they kind of fuse together. I then attach the fronts to these side parts, again using more of this weld bond glue. And here you can finally kind of start to see all of the random shapes that we've been cutting out take, well, shape. Especially after I do the other side of the tower and make our rectangle that we're going to be using. I then measure out the inside of the tower so that I can cover that in a piece of styrene so we don't have any gaps in our main shape. Taking the square that we just cut out and attaching it to the rest of the body of the tower with some more of the weld bond glue. Since the tower itself is tapered, I didn't know how I was going to measure out the shapes for the insides of the sides of the tower. So I decided to trace it and hope for the best. And that ended up working fairly well. However, the pieces were a little bit bigger than they needed to be, but that's better than being too small because I can just take my file and file those down a little bit. Now with the main part of the tower sorted out, I want to go back to the wheels. And I chop out a series of these little styrene strips that I connect together and basically create a little rod that I'm going to be able to use to connect the wheels together. So I add a little bit of the weld bond glue and attach that to the center of both wheels. I then cut out a long strip of styrene and measure out and cut out a bunch of small strips of this. And this is what I'm going to be using for the exterior of the wheel to make it act like a large metal wheel of some kind. And then I attach these guys to the wheel using more of the weld bond glue. And this is really good because it makes sure that the wheels themselves are actually perpendicular and not a little bit askew, as I'm adding more of these pieces of styrene onto the exterior of the wheel. And once all of those pieces are added, I go over the edges of them with a file to make them look a little bit rounded off. Then, to attach the wheel to the tower itself, I add a couple pieces of styrene onto the center of each side of the wheel, making the wheel just a little bit bigger than the actual slot that I've made for it, to make sure that it's connected on both sides. So the next thing I wanted to add to this guy was a little bit of a cutout where I would have one of the Gretchen miniatures from the set of Gretchen that I've got manning some kind of turret or something like that. And so, as you see me doing here, I measure out just how big that's gonna have to be, keeping in mind how big the Gretchen are and what kind of a turret I'm planning on having on there. And once I've got that all measured out, I can take my X-Acto blade and start cutting it out. Retrospectively, it probably would have been a better idea to have cut this out before I had assembled the entire tower, but you know, I don't really think that kind of thing through. I just kind of go through, well, build the tower, add stuff. Maybe next time we'll actually plan it out a little bit better. But as you can see me doing here, I trace out the inside shape for how big the little compartment is going to have to be and cut that out of a piece of styrene. And after doing that for both the top and bottom, I attach those guys with a piece of styrene that's the right height for the compartment. And then to make sure that they're at right angles from each other, I cut out these triangles and use those as supports for the kind of pillar piece of styrene that I'm going to add. And then after doing a lot of finagling off camera, I end up with something that looks like this, which I can then add the rest of the walls to. And the nice thing about making orc stuff is I don't have to make this a perfectly square box. I can make it whatever kind of weird shape I want because it wouldn't be perfectly square in an orc vehicle. But once all that stuff is added, I end up with a little compartment that looks like this, which I actually decide I'm not going to attach the tower quite yet because I don't know all the details I'm going to be putting in this guy when I'm painting it. With that finished, the other thing I wanted to do was create another little compartment, but rather than having it be kind of inside the tower, I wanted to be extruding out of the tower. And so of course, first things first, a whole bunch of measuring to make sure it's going to be the right size. And after I've actually measured the shape, I can start cutting out these little L-shaped pieces that are going to go on the top and bottom of this. And I just cut this out of a scrap piece of styrene I had from another thing that I had cut up earlier. Also, what you don't see here is I did a little bit of filing down on the inside of these guys to make sure that they had a snug fit over the tower. And then I take a little bit of the weld bond glue and slap those guys on there. And then I start adding all of the plating around it except for the front plate, because I'm going to want to do that later when I add some of the miniatures to this. Then to finish off the main shape of the tower, I cut out a large piece of styrene and glue that onto the top of the tower. And then I take a file and file down the edges of that so that it's nice and even. And then, of course, because I don't think anything through, I realized that I wanted the top of the tower to actually have like two tiers to it. So I measure out where I want the second tier towards the back of the tower to be, and then go in with a craft knife to chop this out. Again, this kind of thing would be way easier if you thought it through beforehand and cut all the pieces to be the right shape already. So don't do what I do. I am dumb. Self-deprecation aside, I take the two pieces that we had just cut out and stick them back in, just inverted, so that we have kind of two tiers to our tower now, trimming them a little bit to make sure that they actually fit. And here you can actually see what it looks like. And what I also wanted to have was a little bit of an overhang coming from the top tier over top of the lower tier. So I cut out this odd shape and add a little piece of styrene underneath it. Basically, this is going to make the transition from the lip look a little bit smoother and less like I just kind of stuck something over top of it. Now that the main shape of the tower is finally finished, I can start adding some of the details and figuring out how to make it look a little bit more orky and slapped together. And the way that I do this is basically by adding larger pieces of styrene to make it look like this vehicle was covered in just different sheets of scrap metal. As you can see me doing here, I take a file and edit the inside of this piece so that it goes around the little compartment that we added towards the top of the tower. This piece in particular is also going to add as a little bit of a railing for all the guys over top of the tower as well. Once that piece fits around the compartment nicely, I can attach that with some styrene, but I also chop off the top to make it look less streamlined or clean. I then continue to cut out more shapes to add onto the top of the tower. For this guy in particular, since it's going over top of another piece of styrene that I added, I need to add another piece of styrene to the inside of this guy in the same way that I did for the little overhang on the top of the tower. You can see that guy right here and how he kind of will slot in to the little bit of styrene left over from the last piece that we added. And for these two pieces that kind of come up to the edge of the tower, I also add another piece to make it look like the sheet of metal is wrapping around the tower. Using a file to file down the edges and make sure that the two pieces blend into each other. I then also bevel all the edges of the pieces that I add. After this, it's just a case of going around and adding more of these pieces of styrene to make the entire piece look ramshackle and slap together and make sure that the entire project has a really good orky, kind of scrappy feel. One detail that I also add is a railing between these two pieces of styrene, using some super glue to attach the toothpick that I chopped up between the two pieces of styrene. To make it feel a little bit more orky, I also take the ends of the toothpick that I chopped off and attach those to the outside of the railing to make them look like kind of spiky pieces of metal. So, as you can see in this drawing that I had done, I wanted to give this guy one of those kind of orc jaw-like wheel coverings, since on a lot of orc vehicles it seems like they kind of have them looking like an orc face or something. So I cut out a rectangle of styrene and start to try to figure out how I'm going to get this look across. So I decided I was going to cut some kind of like rhombus shapes for the panel shapes that are going to go right beside the main kind of rectangle that we had just cut out. I then take some of these scrap pieces that have 45 degree angles cut into them, and I'm going to use these guys as a reinforcement so that the shape is nice and strong, as well as the angles being consistent. Also, rather than making like perfect rhombus shapes, I chop out some like kind of spikes on the top of these side parts of the jaw, and that will help kind of make it look like teeth. Then attach that to the supports that I had added before. And here you can kind of see what it's going to look like once it's finished. I then cut out and attach the other side of this jaw, making sure the spike that I cut out is a little bit off from the one that I added before, to make sure it's not too symmetrical. Then I cut out the bits that are actually going to be attached to the tower themselves, or the jaw bones, so to speak. I then cut out and attach the other side of the jaw, again cutting it into a slightly different shape. I then cut out and attach even more pieces of styrene. And the idea with these guys is that they're actually going to be doing two things. Firstly, they'll help sell the kind of orky slap together look, but I'm also going to use them to strengthen all of the connections between the different pieces of styrene that we added before. Since once I've added all of them and filed them down a little bit, I get rid of all the little structural bits we added before, since they kind of stand out on the miniature and make it difficult to attach the jaw to the rest of the tower. And then in the same way that I attach the wheel onto the inside of the tower, I add some little bits of styrene and attach this guy to the outside of the tower. I then add some extra little pieces of styrene to act as little patchwork pieces of metal, and add some extra little spiky bits all over the place to make it feel nice and orky. Something I also wanted to add was a manhole on the side of the tower with a couple Gretchen falling out of it. So then I cut out two little polygons and take out the insides of them so that they can kind of turn into these little manhole. And then I glue that onto the tower itself. I also wanted to make a ladder for the top of the tower to get from the top tier to the bottom tier. So I chop up some toothpicks, making obviously two longer pieces and a bunch of smaller pieces, and begin to attach those together with some super glue. And once I've completely assembled the ladder, I can then go and attach that onto the miniature itself. Again, just using a bunch of super glue to do that. And then comes a slightly tedious part of the project. I mix together a little bit of Milliput and roll that out into some thin little like noodles. And this Milliput is basically a two-part epoxy that dries into a hard clay-like substance. And after I've let the Milliput harden, I cut it up into little pieces and add those as bolts around the entirety of this project. And while this is a very tedious step, it's really, really important and really just completes the miniature. But once I go around and cover the entire project in these little bolts, so, I'm going to leave this project there. So far, I'm very, very happy with how this is turning out. I think that it looks really, really cool, and I really can't wait to get to the next part, which is actually incorporating all of the miniatures into this project. I think that adding those little bolts that I've added to the other projects, but after I've added all those tiny little bolts, it just looks so good, and it already just has a great orky feel to it, even though it's not painted or doesn't have any miniatures on it yet. So, in the next part of this project, I'm going to be doing the rest of the build for this miniature. So you can look forward to that in the upcoming video. But if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell to get notified when I release new videos. And I'll be trying to get back to as many comments as I possibly can. But obviously, I'm not actually home. I'm doing some work abroad and don't have time to actually produce videos, and that's why all of these videos are pre-recorded. If you're interested in what I'm doing, you can check out the update video that is on the front page of my channel for more information. But anyways, thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.